It's you, Tim.
Come on, Peter.
Oh, who cares?
Tim,
it's the swoosh.
Tim,
it's the most classic logo in the history of sports.
I got to tell you, Tim, I feel confident about answering this question because every time I would defend something like this, people, oh, he's being a Yankee boy. I have long said that ads on the uniform don't bother me. I remember last year we had a big discussion, GE on the Celtics uniform. Oh, how hideous. After 10 games, you won't even notice it's there. It's a small swoosh pays. And it's not the Yankees' choice. It's a Major League Baseball initiative.
And also, hold on. We will not for one second act as if having a swoosh on a jersey is even in the same conversation as having a GE logo on a jersey. Swooshes have been on jerseys in every other sport. Hockey jerseys, for years, the CCM logo was part of what a hockey jersey was. Then after that, Reebok, whatever. In every sport, hey, Rawlings, these logos have always existed.
Listen,
it's a swoosh.
You know, the swoosh was on the Penn State jersey, where they don't have a logo on their helmet, they don't have the names on the back either, but yet they had that on their jersey because that's the brand, right? So it's not like you're putting Chico's bail bonds on the jersey,
right?
Or Clixies. I got to tell you, everybody, I've read Twitter all day. A lot of people are outraged. I'm a capitalist. I can't be that fired up. I know the Yankee uniform is classic. And now, if you want to have a problem with the way the uniform looked in the thing that the YES Network, the pinstripes on the shoulders are running in different directions than ever before. That's kind of jarring to me. I don't know why they made that decision.
Where is that?
Yeah, because like the pinstripes in the past would go right up to the seam,
right,
and then go back. Now the pinstripes are running from neck to shoulder blade on the top. That looks a little bit jarring. The swoosh does nothing for me. I don't care.
I guess the point, Michael,
I believe in making
that
money.
That bothers people. And you're right. And it's happening. And it's not even like the Yankees are doing it themselves.
Whoa.
Major League Baseball is forcing them to do it.
So the stripes normally used to just go over the shoulder straight.
Right.
The way they are going up the jersey.
Yeah.
And now they get to the shoulder and cut the other direction.
Yeah.
That is different.
It's
so
different.
If
but
these things are happening.
Sorry, Don. One last thing. So this deal with Nike won't last forever. It'll be a cool period where the jerseys from that time period had a swoosh. It differentiates a time period.
I just can't get that fired up about it.
But all I'll say to play devil's advocate a bit, because I fundamentally agree with you, especially with the logo of the jersey maker. I mean, like you said, hockey's been doing it forever. It's Reebok now. It was CCM forever. You see, the helmet, the same thing. It's been going on forever. Is that the Yankees held themselves to a different standard to where if I'm going to have the Nike logo, if I'm going to have on Players Weekend all white jerseys or the softball jerseys from 2 years ago, if I'm going to change it occasionally, then what are you even standing up for, but we won't put the names on the back or we won't have a third jersey? It just seems like the compromises are being made here. So the one great thing about the Yankees is they held themselves to a different standard. No facial hair. We don't put names on the back. We don't change the jerseys. The road grays and the home pinstripes, that's the way it is. But once you start breaking some of those things down, what are you even holding on to anything for now? Well, you know how much money they can make if they had like a special Yankee jersey on Sundays that they wore all that?
I'm just going to get everybody set for it. There's going to be ads on jerseys. You see it when they play the games in foreign markets.
I don't ever want to see that.
But you will see
it. But I don't think you should have to be a walking billboard. I don't think it's a NASCAR, all right? No, I can understand you have the little logos there.
Right.
But where do you draw the line?
You're going to put something on the shoulder patch.
But what happens if Bud Light's going to pay $1 billion to Major League Baseball to have a little Bud Light can on the breast, and meanwhile there's going to be players that are known alcoholics are going to say, I don't want a Bud Light. So you do have to stop at some point.
I don't know.
With NASCAR, it's different. NASCAR, if I've got Tide on my car, I'm doing advertisements for it. I've got it in my home. I'm all in on Tide. You can't do that with ball players because what if it's something they're against? What if it's something they don't like?
Well,
what if it's something that they actually have a relationship with somebody else?
Aren't there billboards of beers all over the place? They sell beer.
But that's the team. But now I'm a player, and I've got to wear that.
No, I get.
I have a drinking problem, or maybe I make money with Budweiser, but now my jersey for the Yankees is going to be, something else.
Yeah, but I think they'd probably draw the line because they don't allow players to advertise liquor while they're active players. But if you put a Kohl's ad or a Neiman Marcus ad or a Macy's ad, I mean, are people's head going to explode? They're not.
No, but I'm not. But I can look like I'm not a billboard. If the jersey's a Nike jersey and they want to have their logo on there,
why are we dying on that hill? Soccer players have it all. The teams are named after things.
And in hockey in Europe, it's the same way. But I just think it looks ridiculous. I think it looks ridiculous in soccer that basically it looks like I'm playing for a brand. Meanwhile, I don't even know the name of the team. But they don't care because all their teams are named United anyway, so it doesn't matter.
All right, we're going to take a break.